Allah!
See what I tell you?
Little demon.
As soon as I come, you get triggered. It's like a chemical reaction.
This is Allah's number.
The kryptonite to the Trinitarians.
What is about this man? He's the demon.
It's called John 17:3.
Really?
It's Allah.
John 17:3. You know why he gets angry? Because he knows the Trinity is only devil inspired.
Allah's number one demon. He's number one demon.
And you're the number one demon of all the Trinitarians. Yes. No wonder you're scared.
The thing about
the Trinity was invented by the demon, and that is what you follow. Even Jesus, you know, even Jesus.
No. Anything you need.
Even Jesus is against the Trinity. Why?
So he has to call me a demon.
And what about you? You're the devil. You're the devil, Satan. You know why he doesn't want to talk about the Trinity? Because even he knows.
I'm happy to talk about the Trinity.
Really? Let's not talk then. Come on.
No, I want to talk about Aisha in the bath with Muhammad praying with her.
Why?
With my Aisha praying with her when she was 6 years of age. Defend it.
Why
defend it?
I asked for the Trinity.
You defend it.
You're scared of the Trinity.
You defend it.
You're the Trinity.
You're a disgusting
man. No wonder.
You're a disgusting
human being. You're a pervert. You're a disgusting pervert. All you think about is sex.
You're a disgusting human being.
That's all you talk about.
You're a disgusting human being.
Yeah. No wonder.
Calm down.
Yeah.
Can we have a conversation?
No, not with you. Because you're another demon. This is another demon. Another liar. Another liar.
You're a Satan.
This is another liar.
Why do you talk like a Satan?
Don't entertain. Don't speak to him.
Let him shout. Let him shout. Let him shout.
Your blood pressure's gone up.
No. Let him shout. Let him shout. Everyone, I request. Let him keep shouting. Keep shouting.
Can someone call the doctor?
Keep shouting.
All he did was bend.
Let him continue.
Oh, you got destroyed by him.
Wait.
You're embarrassed.
We can still have a conversation.
Stop acting like a Satan. Can you stop acting like a Satan?
If you want.
No, you can't. I don't think you can have
a gentleman.
Don't you?
You're not honest.
Okay.
You're not an honest man.
Look who's talking about honesty.
Let people decide.
No, I don't want to. This lot, they need to decide.
No. The people are watching online.
Yes, okay, good.
Let them decide.
Let them decide.
You want to have a conversation?
You're a deceiver, and this is number one demon.
Let people
decide. And you're the Satan.
No.
You're the Satan.
Yeah. Wait. No, okay.
All you've got to look, brothers and sisters, online.
Can we have a conversation?
Look at this
man's face. Look at this man's face.
Can we have a conversation?
Look at his ticket.
Not with you.
No, triggered.
I have no respect for you. I've seen you.
So what?
You're a deceitful man.
How can I deceive people when you're talking against me?
I've got to go.
Of course you got to go, because you've been the ghost. You have been exposed again. So the liar.
The point we're trying to prove
here.
The point we're trying to prove here. Gentlemen like this cannot have a decent conversation. They don't want to. They don't want to. You know why?
Gentlemen is questionable for him.
When we do have a decent discussion, they are...
He's going to run away now. Watch him.
Can I say?
No,
can I speak?
Yes, you can. You can. You want to have a conversation?
Just look how many people are screaming at me.
No one's screaming.
How many demons?
Not one.
One, two, three. And
who's
the little demon here, the little parrot. Another one here.
You see how scared he is?
Yeah.
He's scared. He's calling everyone a demon.
Who's shouting?
I need to go.
Who's screaming?
I'm happy to answer any question.
No, you're not. You're scared.
Any person that comes over here knows that I will answer any
question. No, you are not. You are scared.
Why is it that you cannot have a conversation? Why can you not have a conversation?
Because he's scared.
Islam. You've done it for so long.
Because I want to leave you all with
Islam is the truth which is afraid of.
Hashim, don't shout. Have a conversation.
He's afraid of the truth.
Conversation. I'll ask him a question. I want to ask you a question.
Yes.
When did you become a Muslim?
I became a Muslim when I was
born.
23.
And how did you become a Muslim?
Wow, that just shows.
I embraced Islam as my own choice. Not because I was born.
What were you before that?
I don't know.
You don't know what you were before?
No, I don't know.
What were your parents?
My parents are Muslims.
So you were a Muslim then?
I did not practice Islam.
It doesn't matter. You were a Muslim. See, the deceit comes straight out. Good night, folks. The deceit comes straight out of his mouth. Anybody can see that this man is a deceiver. A deceiver. And you are a deceiver. It's the parrot again. My point is... The point is...
That you are a Satan.
I wanted him to say that he was a Muslim.
Okay. No shouting.
He embraced him when he was 20. priest, but his parents.
I thought you were having a conversation. What happened?
You can talk to me.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, you can talk to me.
You're all a bunch of liars.
Oh, don't be stopping now. Now he's saying everyone.
You should all be ashamed of me.
No problem.
And you, the greatest of all, because you're a deceiver. And that's why I want to debate you. Because you're a liar and a deceiver. And the people.
He speaks like the Satan as well.
I asked him when he became a Muslim. And he said when he was 23.
And what's wrong with that?
Yes.
His parents.
And you think that's funny and laughing?
No one's talking to you. Get away from
would
here.
They not take him to
another devil.
Is that the case?
Another devil comes in.
Can you just tell us why did you lie about the damn Gulubekistan?
Get away from me.
So this is chance to you. Can you explain
okay.
it
my response.
Why did you lie?
One set at a time.
We're having a conversation.
One set at a time.
I'm actually going to go soon. I will
of course you have to go. Because you've been exposed as a liar.
Have a conversation before you go. I have seen you.
Don't talk about seeing me. Answer questions. Why? You're an intelligent man. You're an intelligent man. You see, brothers, he's an intelligent
no.
man.
We're trying to discuss. I call it background noise.
This is what they do. First, oh, you're shouting.
Go cry somewhere else.
You don't give somebody a chance to speak. Oh, you don't answer the question.
Let me respond.
If you want to have a conversation, have a conversation.
Yes. What I like in the park is conversation, not shouting.
Well, then ask a question.
I hope I can have a conversation for a few minutes, but I have to go.
Ignore.
You were attacking.
We call it background noise.
No, I was attacking Islam. I love Muslims.
Okay.
I love Muslims. Okay. That's why.
No, you don't love Muslims.
I do. I even
you
love
call
you.
It doesn't you mean just call me demon. How can you say love?
It doesn't matter. You need to.
That means you're a liar.
You need to face reality.
No wonder Jesus
you
calls you.
You need to wake up to what you say.
Hashim,
you said you love Muslims and you hate Islam. How can you hate the seed and love the fruit? Explain that to me.
Hate the fruit. What are you?
The seed is Islam and the fruit is Muslim.
I don't see it like that.
So how do you see it?
How can I?
It just went over.
Hang on a minute. I'm going to give you one more chance.
Yes.
You didn't understand that
question.
Yes.
Now, ignore. Is he gone?
If you ask,
see what I mean? Background noise.
Don't
shout. But if you're not shouting, I have a loud voice. I still have a loud voice.
Okay. I have louder than yours.
Well, again, supremacy. Again, supremacy. He's got a louder voice than me.
This guy is so wrong.
So what?
Insincere, honestly.
So what, brother? What are you doing?
You're embarrassing Christians around the world.
No, you are. I'm saying to you,
people tell me all the time that I do embarrass Christians sometimes, but I accept that.
You see,
but you are embarrassed. I say Christians embarrass Christians more than Muslims
no,
do.
No, you
I think he's embarrassing himself, if you ask me.
Because you're so full of pride.
See what I mean?
No,
pride.
I'm not.
Oh, you are, brother.
Nobody's talking.
Pride, I would be shouting
you're so
at you.
Full of pride.
Okay.
There's an English word for it as well. But you're so full of pride that you embarrass
me. Pride is an English word.
You see, now I've stood here for 10, 15 minutes and I've got nowhere with this guy. So why should I want to go home? Why shouldn't I just walk away?
Are you being because blocked by Muslims?
It's not you're being blocked. I'm not being blocked.
Okay.
But I gave you the courtesy
I only came in to have a conversation.
But you're not
as
having
humans,
a conversation.
As humans.
As an educated man, you've not asked a sensible question yet.
I haven't asked any question yet.
Exactly. Okay. Well, you have.
Yeah. Okay.
You asked me about peas and fruit.
Maybe you should ask him a question.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Let's ask him a question. Go on.
We see you every single week in the park.
Glory be to God.
Okay, that's fine. We see you...
Heckling,
shouting, screaming at Muslims, behaving
and calling names.
It's a conversation.
Fight, it's a conversation.
Shout. Why
shouting? Speaking.
Well, you're the only one shouting.
And there's five people shouting. When there's five people shouting at me.
Why are you shouting?
I'm shouting.
Well, calm down.
Because I'm proving to you, brother, that I can talk to you.
Don't shout.
Yes. But then, don't
have
say
a mic
that
in front of you.
No, don't say that I'm shouting.
You are.
When
you are shouting.
I'm shouting to prove to you.
Calm down.
When there's five
calm
people
down,
shouting
calm
at me,
down.
I have to shout okay. above you.
He's the only one speaking
what
to you.
What is your problem?
You see, I'll tell you my problem. I'm talking to you. Hashim has to answer for you.
No, I said he's the only one speaking.
Yes, you can't.
You're a very insecure man. Just speak to one person.
Speak. We've got the parrot here on my right that's always answering.
You see, calling names, that's all you do.
She knows I love her, and she knows
really?
I'm admitting. Yes.
And you call her a parrot?
It's not a bad thing. A parrot's not a bad animal.
And you call her a demon earlier?
No, I didn't call her
yes,
a demon.
Yes, you did. Demon. You pointed to her.
You just called her an animal.
Stop lying.
I called.
You just
stop
called
lying.
Her
I jumped
animal.
Over her.
Stop
you
lying.
Just called her an animal.
But they call Jesus a lamb,
no.
So for them it's okay.
I jumped over her.
They call their own God an animal.
Over her.
Okay, let's have our conversation. Our decent conversation. Let's break the records today. Let's show the world that this gentleman can have a decent conversation.
Without shouting, without calling names.
Many times. I'm sure you can.
Pride! Now we've got the pride coming
out. Here he goes again. You got him triggered.
Now he can have a conversation. I don't go around telling you all how many Muslims...
I think Adnan knows what buttons to press.
Every week. How many Muslims are changing their life? I don't boast about it, but he's going
to... You got nothing to boast, that's why.
He's going to tell me that he...
The DCC, I got zero converts.
You are embarrassing Christians.
No, you are embarrassing Muslims.
No, you're not.
But embarrassing the God of heaven and earth with your pride, brother. You don't understand what pride is. Pride is being full of your own importance. Okay. I don't claim to be important. You claim to be important.
I'm sorry if you're getting that impression. I don't mean to give that impression.
Then
I'm
take back to, that how much you help, can have conversation.
I'm trying to help both our communities, Christians as well as Muslims. I'm trying to show the world that there are people in this world who want to have decent conversations.
But we spent 20 minutes here and you haven't asked a question yet. All you've done is attack and you want to attack.
Is the camera here?
Yeah, they are here.
Okay, we're going to have to stop. Thank you. Bye now. No, let's stop.
Yeah.
I don't want them.
Saved by the bell.
Nice talking.
God bless you.
Nice
when talking. It's daylight, I'll come again and we can do it perhaps in the daylight.
Okay.
I, honestly,
I don't think he has the ability.
Yes, but brother, with respect, I'm going to make sure that none of your parrots around you are going to interrupt. All right? Or your demons.
Okay.
And if you want to agree with that, I'll talk to you.
Okay.
But if they're going to keep jumping in with little quips, that's not a conversation.
How old are you?
76.
That's a big
76.
Grow up.
Grow up.
That's what
you
I would
see?
Say.
You see?
No, I didn't say that.
Oh, the little demon made a joke.
I didn't say that.
No. I love
I'm
him.
Saying,
no, you don't.
I love him.
No, you don't.
When you come
doesn't
to
mean
no,
I don't want to spank him.
Okay. No.
I love him.
Wait. No, you
Hashim,
don't.
Hashim wants to...
Go home and spank someone in your family,
want,
maybe.
Because, look...
That's what you're used to.
Facts on the ground. Thousands of people are watching our videos around the world.
Yeah.
Right? We must represent our communities decently.
Why don't you act decently then?
Yeah, I'm trying to.
But you're not. You start the conversation with full of pride.
No, he doesn't know.
You can't measure pride. You can't.
You can measure pride.
You can't have a...
We can measure pride because Satan fell from heaven because of his pride, brother.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the advice. I'm saying we must, when we do have conversations in the park, we must remain civil. We must calm down. We cannot shout at each other because people don't learn from shouting. They learn from conversation.
Brother, with respect, I've let you say something. I agree with you. But if you're going to have your parrots and your demons around you shouting at me...
And look at the language you're using again.
Because I'm going to stand up to them. I'm not frightened of them. I will stand up to them.
Okay, look.
Do you understand?
There is
I'm not frightened
of them. There is a person...
They are not going to bully me.
This lady here, next to me...
I just said grow up.
She is notorious for making more commentary.
Again, brother, with respect.
I'm talking.
With respect.
Would you give the same advice to them?
He says he wants to have a conversation.
Yes.
And now from me...
Adnan, ask them if you'll give the same advice to these Christian fellows.
That's okay for you to attack other people.
Okay.
Why don't you stick and attack me instead of bringing another lady into it that has not got the right to answer? And you're not even going to let her answer.
Can we have conversations?
We can, but you've got to understand, brother, you don't know what debate is and you don't know what conversation is in a civilized manner.
Perhaps you can teach me how to debate.
I'm teaching you as we go along. Okay. As we go along.
So let's do that. Let's do that. Okay. We can talk about Christianity and Islam without shouting at each other, without insulting each other.
As long as your demons don't start shouting.
Stop interrupting. Just listen for once.
Without damaging each other's eardrums.
Yeah. As long as... Look, you have to have the echoes with you. Why do your boys have to echo you?
Just listen.
Hatun, who's standing
Mansour
next to me...
Mansour doesn't allow people to talk.
Wait.
Mansour doesn't allow people to talk around him. he can't answer this.
Mansour, you can answer this.
Yes. He doesn't allow people to answer.
Okay.
If anybody says anything, brother, stop.
No.
And they all go silent.
Wait.
Why is it when I'm talking, 10 of you, 5 of you...
That's because you've got
shouting.
People demon, that's why.
No one's shouting
Practice
at you.
Practice what you preach.
No, no one is
that's
shouting
That's why I said,
at you.
Grow up.
I'm talking to you. Oh, sorry. Listen.
As soon as somebody talks, you call them demons. That is not the type of... teaching that people want
you. You're 76 years old. I want to respect you.
I don't want you to respect me. Listen, this brother here.
You call me brother now? Earlier you called me a demon.
He's heard what we're saying. He's heard my objections to having a conversation.
No wonder he's so insecure.
And he can't stop. He can't stop. They've got a motor.
Why don't you ignore him and talk to me?
I don't think he has the ability.
I'm trying to think to talk to you, and he has to ask.
But why
do you get triggered all the time?
She came and shouted earlier. Yeah. I ignored her. I didn't even entertain her.
Brother.
Because I have no time for shouters. Brother. With people who shout. With look, she's going to start again.
Brother.
And
brother.
She's going to damage my right eardrum.
Brother.
Yeah.
Brother.
And I'm going to do the right thing. I'm going to protect my right eardrum.
Okay. Let's move away.
I have to protect my eardrums. You have no idea
how bad
the weapon Hatun has. She has a very strong, powerful weapon that can penetrate through your brain and damage you internally.
Glory to God. Okay. Glory be to God that she gets through to your brain.
Before I lose my brain cells and my eardrums, I'm going to have to make a move.
Actually, listen, brother.
Okay, who's my son?
If you want to be serious,
yes.
I want to be serious.
Yes, she's not on our side. By the way, stop pushing, guys. Calm down, calm down.
Relax, Hashim, relax.
I'm relaxed. I'm relaxed here. The only guy's pushing is this.
She's pulling it. Take it. Let
I'm not pulling it. You out of He's talking about double standards now.
Why can't we have decent conversations?
I keep explaining to you, and I know you're an educated man. I'm not an educated man, but I am.
Just cover their cameras.
If I'm talking to you, and there's people interceding all the time.
I agree.
How can we have a conversation?
But if we always agree to start in a decent setting, we can always set rules. We can tell people not to heckle.
Yes.
We can tell people not to.
But he couldn't help answering. He had to answer.
Now, can I have
triggered by me?
Can I have a very decent conversation with you before you leave? Very quickly. You raised a question earlier. You were talking about the Prophet of Islam getting married to a younger woman, and you had a problem with that.
I didn't have a problem with that.
Yeah.
No, you see, because everybody's shouting, it was a misunderstanding.
Okay.
It's not that I've got a problem with Muhammad marrying a six-year-old girl. The problem is that you claim that he's the best example for mankind, which means that people in Afghanistan now, 50-year-old men, are marrying 6 or 7-year-old girls, 25 of them, they're all walking down the road with their child bride. So that's where it's wrong.
Okay. You're absolutely right. If people are doing that, they are absolutely wrong to do that. Firstly, let us establish what we're talking about here. The Prophet did not marry Aisha at 6. You give the wrong impression. Let me clarify. I know exactly what he did. I know exactly how it was done. Can you move down? So now that we are having a decent discussion, we're going to get to some conclusions. And I hope you won't bring this topic up again if it has been answered satisfactorily. Okay?
Okay, now I'm going to answer that.
Yeah.
He's just said to me, I won't bring up the topic of Muhammad marrying Aisha if it's explained properly. Okay.
Okay.
If you all promise to never mention anything about the Bible again, because you've all had the answer. You've all had it all explained to you about the dogs, about the mother. You've had it all explained to you, but this demon comes week after week with the same questions, looking for vulnerable
questions.
Let's talk
questions. To me. Let's talk to
yeah.
me.
Okay. He's looking for vulnerable
ignore,
questions.
Ignore others.
So you can't have ignore. It both ways.
Okay.
Either you all stop talking about my Bible, and then I won't mention your...
Okay, now what you're saying is, you do it deliberately. You keep bringing back the same question.
No, not the same question.
Even though it's been answered, you do it deliberately to get back to us, because we keep doing the same with the Bible. Is that
no,
what you're
no,
saying?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that it's a disgusting thing to practice today.
The point
of what I'm saying is not that Muhammad had a six-year-old, because we know that things did go on like that. The point
How did they go? Tell
Now,
tell
let me
us.
Just say this.
Yeah.
You claim that Muhammad is the greatest example to mankind.
Absolutely.
And he
so
cannot
I do apologize to because these guys are maybe deliberately raising their voices.
He
or something
cannot be the greatest example to mankind.
Yeah. Absolutely. We believe he was the greatest example.
But he can't be.
Okay, why not?
Because he was in the bath with a six-year-old child playing with her. He said to one of his companions, why did you marry an older woman?
Okay.
Why did you marry an old... Why didn't you get yourself a child
That's
you
a very
play
good,
with?
You raised a very good point. Can you show me now anywhere in our literature that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam
peace be upon him, was in a bath with 6 years old child. Show me
it's
anywhere.
It's a hadith from
Show me, I'm waiting.
No, I haven't got it.
Please, please.
No, I haven't got it.
It's a decent discussion, remember?
It is. Remember, I've got to tell you, brothers, because this is important.
No, no, before you leave.
No, I'm not leaving. I want to just answer it.
So can you at least accept that this information doesn't exist?
No, I'm not going to accept it.
Okay. If you don't accept it, show it to me. I insist that you, because you made a claim. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 cameras, and this footage is going to go around the world outside.
Yeah.
And people now, they have seen you made a claim.
Yeah.
I am challenging you in a decent fashion to produce the evidence.
Yeah.
If the evidence is non-existent, you claim that Muhammad was in a bath with a 6 years old child. I am asking for the evidence.
Okay. Anybody that knows me, that I've been coming over this park, I don't bring evidence, because when you refer to the hadiths or the Quran,
then at least admit that you have been misguided.
You see, you didn't. I'll let you speak.
Yeah.
If I mention the hadith or the Quran, they say, but you have to read it in the Arabic.
No.
It's a waste of time.
Bring it in English. You can bring it in English.
It's a waste of
Even Punjabi, I can read it.
It's a waste of time me learning these hadiths and these Quranic verses.
Wait.
It's a waste of time.
Let him find it.
I've had many conversations over here.
If it exists, let him find it.
I had many conversations over here with Muslims without references. And when they say something from the Bible, even if they misquote it, I don't hold them to it. And we have conversations.
No, but again,
we come to conclusions.
To be responsible with the information
here, the experts here that think they're the experts.
Okay.
They come here learning the same thing.
Talk to the student.
Right.
Okay. I'm asking you a question.
They come here with their verses from the Bible. They know more about the Bible than the Quran.
My dear brother, you just made a claim.
Let me just answer.
And I'm trying to correct you that you're wrong. You are wrong. Such information does not exist. There is no information on the claim.
You bring it.
Okay. If you cannot bring it, okay. Let's get a commitment on camera.
Yeah.
If you cannot bring such information,
no.
Then what? Are you going to apologize?
Give me another week. No.
Another week.
I know it's there. But you have to.
What if it's not there? Are you going to retract your statement or not?
It is there.
What if it's not there?
So next week.
It's not there. You haven't seen it.
Wait, brother, let me speak to him.
It's a hadith by Aisha.
Okay. I'm going to repeat his claim. He made a claim, this gentleman, he made a claim that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was in a bath with a 6 years old child. Right? I want him to now. And it is a fair thing to do. I want him to now substantiate that from any piece of information.
Right.
If he cannot do it.
Yeah. And if I
the next
it,
week,
are you gonna
the
say
week after,
it's Suhail? Are you gonna say it's not legitimate?
No, I'm telling you that
if
right now.
If I bring you an Arabic scripture that says that she was in the bath with Muhammad and she washed his thighs, are you going to say that this is not authentic?
Okay.
You see, I know.
No, wait.
I know the tricks, brother. They get out of it by changing it.
Let me. You. It's been recorded. Thankfully, it's been recorded. You made a claim. Your claim was very specific. Muhammad was in a bath with a 6 years old.
Yeah.
I want you to substantiate that.
Okay.
Whether she was washing his thighs, his head, his chest, or whatever.
I
want you to show me a report that Muhammad was in a bath with a 6 years old child.
And if I do.
Okay.
You're not going to claim it's not authentic.
Did you get the claim?
Are you going to get that? You're not going to say it's not authentic. Because if you do, I will never speak to you again.
No. I won't. Okay.
If you don't.
Okay.
If you don't bring it, you will examine it.
If I don't bring it, it's because I haven't had a chance. But my whole life is not revolved around looking for hadiths and Quranic verses. I have a life.
Okay.
I enjoy coming over here.
Okay.
I mean, many people.
Wait. Yeah. Okay. So if the information is non-existent,
then what? The information is existent.
If not, then what?
Okay.
It is.
Okay. If it is non-existent,
it is.
Okay. Wait. If it is non-existent.
It is existent.
If it is non-existent.
But it is.
It's not going to be.
Why do you not have it? Why do you not have it?
If it is non-existent.
But it is.
So how come you don't have it right now?
You see?
No. Talk to me.
Can you have a conversation with me?
You can have a conversation with me. You can have a conversation with me.
Yeah. Right. I want to go. Anyway,
perhaps they can help you. You can ask them.
Listen.
You know, they have a big research team.
Listen.
Ask them. Even they will tell you, hold on, you just put yourself in a pit. You won't be able to climb out of it.
If I put myself in a pit,
yeah,
I will be the first to apologize.
Thank you. Gentlemen. That's okay. What we want. And once you do apologize, we will not use it against you again.
You can. I expect you to. No.
Don't expect. We are a good people.
Good.
You haven't had much time with Muslims. I can see that.
I have.
You need to spend some more time.
Yes, I do. I know plenty of Muslims.
How much time have you spent with Muslims?
You know nothing about me.
Have you been to a Muslim country?
I love everybody.
Okay, good.
I love everybody, and I love you.
You don't seem to.
I'm angry with you.
You love him.
It's difficult, but I do.
He hesitated. Did you see that? He hesitated.
You see, just because I'm actually angry with him for the things he said.
Why are you angry with me? Because I talk about the Trinity?
No.
Then why?
You don't remember
what
you said. You don't remember the terrible thing that you said to me.
Give me one thing.
You don't remember the thing. You're lucky you're still standing.
Which is what?
Which is what? You're lucky you're still standing.
Is that a threat?
Yes.
Please.
Yes.
That's why I said grow up.
Yes. Why did you say what you said to me?
Oh, because I said grow up.
No.
Then what?
See?
What did he say?
I will tell you in private.
Why?
This man is disgusting. He is disgusting.
But do you love him?
I love him, of course.
Okay.
I still love him, but he is disgusting.
You love disgusting people?
He's not a man. This is another one. This is number
one. Do you normally tell people who you love that they're disgusting?
Yes! You need to be told.
I feel sorry for your family.
You need to be Do not understand that sometimes you have to say to somebody, brother, you're out of order. What you're doing, what you're saying.
On a positive note, what I would like to end with is a lot of the times our Christian friends, in some cases ignorantly, not deliberately, in some cases they are ignorant. They are genuinely misled and misguided about our Prophet. They haven't read about our Prophet. They don't know our Prophet. They have been taught lies by some missionaries, and they come and express these lies in public, thinking this is the truth. We want our Christian brothers and sisters around the world to read about the Prophet from authentic Islamic sources. You will see that he was a very morally upright man, a compassionate man, a generous man.
Did he kill the woman with five children and kill the 120-year-old man?
That information is not authentic, by the way. That's why I said authentic. These are fabrications. Okay, these are fabrications. I'll tell you why. We have 34,000 reports about the Prophet and his life in six books. Okay, almost, if you put them all together without repetition, we have about 5,000 authentic reports on the life of the Prophet. There are teachings about orphans, there are teachings about widows, there are teachings about
why was adopting children stopped in the time of Muhammad?
No.
Oh, really?
That's wrong.
Really?
That's a misconception.
Oh, it is. You can adopt children now, but they don't take your family name. Why don't they take the family name?
Okay, that's a different matter now.
It's a different matter because he married his son's daughter, a wife.
Okay.
You picked the wrong person.
I picked the right person,
no,
I think.
No, you didn't, brother.
Okay, let's talk.
You didn't, brother.
Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it.
All speculation.
So the conclusion is, what do we see here? I had a debate recently in Australia, and this person I debated, his name is Bernie Power, and he is a PhD doctor. And when I debated him, I thought he will bring up some sophisticated arguments, some academic arguments against Islam and Muslims, or for that matter against the Prophet of Islam. But his arguments were so crude and so ill-informed and ignorant that I was shocked. He was using inauthentic information taken from some Islamic sources, because we have a plethora of sources. Some of them are authentic, others are not authentic. How do we determine whether they are authentic or not? This is another topic in itself. We have an entire science dedicated to this. So a lot of the Christian missionaries, what they do is they deliberately ignore thousands of reports on the life of the Prophet, thousands upon thousands, hundreds talking about the rights of the poor, the needy, orphans, widows, even animals. The Prophet talked about the rights of animals. You will never hear these teachings from the mouths of these missionaries. I'm not talking about this gentleman, the people we have been debating and talking to at large. Never will they come out. None of them has the audacity to say Muhammad was a moral man, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Never. What they will do, to the contrary, they will go to some dubious sources. They will pick up some erroneous report, and they will say, "Look, Muhammad did this, sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Right? Why do they do this? They have one purpose in mind. They do not preach from the Gospels. They have nothing, no love to share anymore. With the Muslims, no love. No love anymore. In fact, they have gone so far that some of them are now inspiring white supremacists, right-wing racist attackers who are walking into, they are committing acts of terrorism based upon the lies of these, some of these Christian missionaries. This is why we are out to confront them. We are out to put some sanity in their minds, some knock some sense into their heads by arguing and intellectual debates, because they are, many of them, a bunch of liars. Okay? They pick dubious. Imagine if I went to a Christian and I said, the Gospel of Judah says X, Y, and Z, therefore you have to believe in it. They will tell me, the Gospel of Judah, the Gospel of Mary Magdalene, the Gospel of Thomas, we don't even believe in them. They are lies. This is apocryphal information. We don't believe in it. But they do that to us. They go to dubious information, deliberately choose fabricated lies, and they say Muhammad did this, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But we have thousands of reports about the Prophet of Islam. They completely ignore them. So we will continue with our struggle. Thank you so much for listening. And he has some special love for you.
Yeah, I can see that, yeah.
Do you have anything to add?
Like I say, action speaks louder than words. That's all I
absolutely
need to say.
Absolutely. So the love, for some reason, goes missing for Muslims at large.
Love your enemies.
Yes.
It's all just talk.
Okay, assalamu alaikum.